What is up, everybody? A Spare with a Gun here from Sleepless Night Studios, bringing back the Elite Dangerous series. Woohoo! Alright, so, real quick, first off, let me clarify that this episode's gonna be a little weird. Not entirely sure how all it's going to go, mainly because I haven't actually played this since our last episode. I know, that's shocking, probably. You know, the whole... Ooh, I have a lot of lasers. I don't even remember what my ship is set up to have. Yeah, no joke, I really don't remember. Okay, so I have... Kill warrant scanner, frameshift scanner... That all seems relatively familiar. I was rocking my Fertile Lance, I do remember that part. So I have a course set up here to Kausalia, or Kausalsa, as I'm going to call it from now on, because there is a, according to the forums and everything that I've seen anyway, there's a community goal event here till like December 17th or 13th or something like that, and it's a combat zone one where we get to help the Empire fend off the Federation, which is all well and good, but mainly community goals in combat are where I'm more comfortable with the community goals, and this one makes a lot of money. Let's see if I can get that out of the way. I did find, I think you'll actually be able to see my cursor now, because I found there is an actual hardware cursor mode. So that's pretty cool. So I think, because I noticed a long time ago that in some of my videos no one could see the cursor when I was selecting things, so maybe that'll help out. I don't know. Alright, cool. So, we're making our way over there. Let's get away from this star. Actually, what I wanted to check, I always have to make a new route. Yep, okay. So this one I'll be able to scoop, and then we'll have one more jump over to Kausalsa. I'm pretty sure that's actually supposed to be Kausalia or something, but I think Kausalsa sounds funnier. Alright. One thing, normally I cut out the transitions, but I have to say, it may be the new graphics card, it might be that they've refined, some of the netcode or something, I don't know, but the past two jumps I've made, this is the first time I've played it with my new GTX 960, the frameshift space here is, like, way smoother. I mean, a lot of you might recall before there was usually that, like, jump where it would, like, and it would hang for a second and then it would jump kind of thing. Yeah, this one it seemed to just, like, frameshift drive, activating, and you're there, which is awesome. So yeah, my biggest thing that I wanted to kind of clarify with everybody is bear in mind for a little bit, just for a smidge, mainly like this episode. Frameshift drive. May not be after that. Some of it's like putting an old shoe back on, but some of it I'm gonna have to get back into the swing of things and remember how to do stuff, so if my piloting or power management or something just absolutely sucks, go with it. The other thing is, I didn't really have like a big purpose for this episode or anything, because normally I had a goal in mind before I would start recording, or we were working towards something. Again, it's been so long, I don't know. I am playing the standard game right now, but because I am a, whatchamacallit, the lifetime pass holder thing, whatever, that like Uber expansion they did back in the premium beta, I do have access to both ships, the ship's patch beta and the Horizons beta. So I want to talk a little bit more about that, but I'm going to get to this last stop, fuel up, and then make our last jump and head towards the community goal area, and we're going to do some combat fighting while going over some different stuffs. So I will see you in a moment. Alrighty, we have arrived at Kausalia, also known as Kausalsa. And according to the forums, if they are accurate, I need to head to Angnesi City, which conveniently there seems to be a conflict zone right next to. So I think we're going to go ahead and head there first, because the way the, if, unless they've significantly changed something, you usually get combat bonds, but it only doesn't count towards the community goal if you don't sign into the community goal before you turn them in. So all we'll have to do is go here, shoot up some stuff, and then when we get done, we'll just head back to the city and sign up to the community goal via the bulletin board before turning in the bonds. And that should save us from missing out on anything for the community goal, which would be cool. I don't know. I haven't played this in a long time, though. Like, literally, since my last episode, I haven't actually even gotten back on. I had to do a bunch of patching. The launcher scared me, because it was very different and I didn't know where anything was. So, yeah, I'm as out of the loop as you might expect. The only thing was, when I saw that I had access to the Horizons beta, I did watch the footage. I didn't watch it live, but I did watch the footage from the live stream where the devs explained, like, how to do landings on planets and things like that, which was really, really cool. And I'm definitely looking forward to how that's going to affect the game. Like this being able to just, I just want to land on that planet, you know, stuff like that. I don't think it's quite that robust right now. In that I think there's specific kinds of planets and things that you can land on. Like, if, for example, that was a gas giant or something, I don't think you can land on those. I think it's just, like, moons and other places like that. I know you can't land on anything with an atmosphere. They're, like, non-atmospheric landings right now. Stuff like that. So I know it's its first kind of go-around, but still... Aw, oh, come on! Really, dude? And no, I'm in solo play. I didn't want to jump into open, being so out of practice. Really? Seriously? This is really taking this long to get out of. Come on, stop dancing around the escape vector. No, that's just crap. I was like 3 meters away or whatever. I call them meters. I know they're like megameters, million meters, or whatever. But I was like 3 away from dropping out and somebody tries to interdict me, really. I know we are in a hostile zone. I'm almost tempted, let me know what you guys think about that. I'm almost tempted just to drop out of power play altogether. Because I really don't use it. I mean, I know I did little stints of... Oh jeez, I forgot how my Fertilance sounded. Oh, that scared me. I was like, what in the world? Alright. So we need to join a faction. We want the Emperor's Dawn, I believe. Alright. Ah! Hey now. I just got here. Give me a break. Sure, let's go with that. Trying to remember what my ship was set up for and all the controls and all that good stuff. Alright, let's get some speed, because I'm getting worked on here. I think I gotta remember all my hotkeys and stuff. Oh my gosh, I am so out of practice. Let's try. Yep, there we go. Okay, that's my. Where's his power plant? There we go. Goodness gracious me. Oh, that's right. In the Lance, you have to kind of play with the. You have to kind of play with the engines and stuff while you're flying around. Forgot about that. I'm getting used to it. I'm getting used to it. Though this says Federal Gunship. I don't remember there being a Federal Gunship. Oh, jeez. Come on, man. Move. There we go. Something is working on me. So, I don't know if that's just something for the conflict zone, or if that's something new. That could be something new, I guess. Because he's taking a beating. I remember my ships... Once I got into the Clipper and Plus, I remember my ships were doing a lot of damage. And this guy seems to just be kind of taking a beating. So, but I really don't recognize the ship type either. Ouchie! Sorry about that. Ow. I do recall now, looking at my HUD, that the Lance's shield is... Shields are kind of ridiculous. Wait a minute! Uh-oh. They changed something with the game. His power plant's gone and he's totally sitting still. But he's not dead yet. Oh, same for the life support. I know he can't live after that one. Seriously, did they change something? Cause that's new. I've never seen anything survive without its power plant before. That's definitely new. Really? How do I blow these things up? I'm so out of the loop. I don't know what I'm doing. Alright, you know what? We're just gonna go for the hull. I don't know what's going on. I know this isn't a glitch or anything. I mean, it's the game's working too well for it to be a glitch. But seriously, do you have to... You might have to go... Whoa! 44 grand? Okay. Something is weird. Something is weird. Let's go for a python. Yeah, I don't know what is going on here. I mean, I'm still gonna target the power plant, because it still kind of immobilizes the entire ship, but, oof. And now you've got this whole X thing? Yeah. Woo, boy. Man, am I out of the loop. You go away for, like, a couple of months. Nothing's recognizable anymore. I don't even know how to blow up ships properly anymore. That's just sad. Are your power plants in the same spot? Huh, Mr. Python? Is it still on the bottom of your ship? Or did you change that too? Oh, I'm running too fast. Ouchie, something- wow! Something is lighting me up over here. Okay, this... Whatever this other ship is that's... Oh! Well, that explains it. Alright, we gotta move. We gotta move. I don't think I have shield boosters or shield cells on this one anymore. So I gotta put some distance. Oops. We gotta get some distance to get our shields to come back a little bit. Alright, so currently we just have the Conda on our tail. Oh, nope, not anymore. Alright, cool. We're just gonna stop here for a second then. I might actually pause it and just let my shields come back. Because I don't think I have shield boosters anymore, because I only had one fire group. Oh, I have boosters, not... I keep saying boosters. I don't have the cell banks to, like, rapidly get my shields back up. So... Yeah, so I'm just gonna wait here for a minute. And, sorry, I was watching the things. And then I'm gonna come back, and we might try for the Conda, maybe. I might also do some Googleage to see if I can find out how to blow up ships now. So I'll be back in a second. Okay, I'm not sure how long that was, but I think we're back to marginally close to full percentage of shields, so we're gonna head back in. I did also do some research, and apparently that whole power plant thingamabobber is a part of the 1.4 update, which I believe was the latest update, and I think 1.5 is considered ships. The ship's patch, which is currently in beta. What are you? Yeah, let's go for a Viper. Screw it. Why not? So apparently in the new patch, or update, or whatever you want to call it, the power plant is not an insta-kill anymore, but it still, like, takes out the ship, as we saw, like, it'll disable it temporarily. There is apparently a way that you can, I don't know if it's, like, reboot it or what, but you can kind of bring it back online, even if someone's taken it down to zero, which is interesting. And it may prove useful if you find yourself stuck in a situation where they hit your power plant or something. And I really could be wrong, but I feel like they up the amount you make off of the bonds a lot. That could just be me, but... Woo! Where did all these come from? It said no transactions a minute ago. Okay. Must have just lagged and not updated for me when I first logged into the game. Yeah, when I first logged into the game, it totally told me I had no transactions, so I thought I cleared out my bounties the last time I played, but apparently not! Ooh, this could be good or bad. There is a conda, but there's a cluster of these guys over here. Eh, what do you know? We're gonna try it.
Under attack.
Ow. I am still gonna go for the power plant, mainly because it's still the best way to disable the ship. Like, it's still going to just make it stop moving, shooting, doing anything, basically, until you can get the rest of it down. I totally forgot about this on my fertile lands too. It'll totally do that whole chain gun rapid fire thing, which is pretty cool. I don't know if it's as efficient or effective, to be honest, as, like, just waiting till your lasers come back in full or not, but it is a lot of fun to just, like, you know, see a laser Gatling gun, basically. Really, the problem I'm having right now is I'm getting multiple targets, like this. You can see on my HUD, I got two or three different ships that aren't the Conda hitting me. Which is not good, because the Fertile Lance is tough, but, I mean, a 4-on-1 is still not a fair fight at all. For me, anyway. Well, I guess it depends on the ship. If they were rolling, like... Oh, ow, that hurt. Yeah, we're gonna move. Woo! They don't call this high intensity for nothing. I kind of want to kill that Conda, though, just because I want to see what it gives me. Look at that, though. I got, like, five red blips on the radar attacking me all at one time. Not fair. Party foul. I call foul.
Under attack.
Yeah, I know. Thank you. Though his hull is at 68%. Dang, I really wish I had shield cells right now just to get... Because these Fertilance shields take forever to come back. I mean, they take forever to take down. Obviously. Stop poking me! What are you anyway, you jerk? Python. Go away. Oh! What do we got? Eagle, Python, Conda, Eagle. Thought there was a second Conda in there. Which would explain a lot of why my shields are just melting. I think there is, because that one's hull is at 73. And the other one was at 68 or something. So that totally is a different Anaconda. The other thing is I am trying to play it a little bit safe because I don't fully recall what all of my ship's capabilities are in terms of, like, I don't know if I can take on a Python or something with just the one layer of shields. I don't think I'll be able to with two Eagles on my back either. Let's see if I can push some distance between us. If I can drop the eagles and keep the python, I'll probably go after him. But that one eagle is just sticking with him. Which actually kind of makes sense, because I'm pretty sure the eagles are faster. Could be wrong, but let's see if I can get... Yeah, alright, I lost him. Let's see if we can do this. Let's see if we can take him out without picking up the eagles. Woo! Definitely not going to be able to run into him, though. That's not going to work. I don't know about this. He's hurting my shields pretty bad. I think I'm going to lose my shields. Yep. Alright, let's see if we can get out of here. Yep, there we go.
Taking damage.
Not really trying to get away from him. I'm trying to just kind of get my shields back online. If I can hold him at just close enough to where he can't hit me, but enough that I can keep him in range. Wow! I know I put in really good shields and I have boosters and everything, but that's going to take for freaking ever. Alright, well, normally I would cut this and just come back when it was done, but this actually might give me a decent opportunity to go over a couple of things that I wanted to talk about since we're kind of coming back. So I'm just going to leave it at this at the moment and see if we get through everything before I'm ready to come back and talk. So, come back and fight is what I meant. So the biggest questions I had is I kind of just started back where we left off because to me Elite is kind of like an MMO that there's really not a whole point in, oh, we're starting a new season. Why? You're in the same ship with the same upgrades that would take you forever to get back to. So why are we changing that up? So it just made sense to just come back and be like, hey, this is where we left off. It's been a while. Hi, how are you? But the big thing is, like, right now I'm doing the combat zones for the community goal and stuff because it was like it gave me a purpose and gave me kind of something to do. But the other thing is, being a lifetime expansion holder, I do have already access to the betas for ships, the 1.5 update, and Horizons, which is the one where you can get your little SRV buggy and land on asteroids and planets. And I don't know about asteroids, but you can land on small moons and stuff like that and go exploring and driving around and all that kind of crap. Which apparently I thought was going to be a bit more bare bones than it is, because when I was watching the live stream from the developers, there's actually like markers that when you go into your bar and look up a moon or something, it'll actually show you whether or not it has like an outpost on it where you can actually land your ship, not just... I thought you would have to be like in orbit and then drop your buggy or something, but no, this is actually like you can fly over the moons and stuff and land on them, which I was like, oh, this is amazing. I cannot wait till they get you to the point where you can actually see and customize your pilot and walk around with your pilot. I'd say customize, that's my hope. But they have said that eventually you'll be able to like walk around in your ships and stuff like that and get out of your ship as your pilot, which I can't wait for. I don't know if you can customize them, but that would be cool. You can customize everything else, why not? But anyways, so my question to everybody else is, while I am kind of sticking with this as the regular series, would you want to start, say, a Elite Dangerous ships playlist or Horizon beta playlist or something like that, and kind of basically suspend this for the moment and then play the betas so that some of you that may have the game but may not have the betas can see what it's like? Or would you rather just continue to move forward and then when the actual full expansion releases come out, we'll be in a better position, like money-wise to be able to just buy some of the better ships and stuff like that. Because I gotta tell you, the ships are kind of ridiculously priced, in my opinion. I was watching a beta video for the Imperial Cutter, which looks really awesome. It's kind of like a combat clipper. and it was like, the beta cost for the ship was like 12 million, and I was like, really? You know, I remember when, like, if it was a beta for new ships, they were like 500 credits or something stupid. And I was like, 12 million, and it was because the in-game price, once it goes live, is supposed to be like 180 million or something. I was like, oh my gosh, this is stupid. So, let's see if we can't bring this back around here. He had time to recharge his shields, though, so that could be bad. So let's see how this goes. But yeah, so if this doesn't go well, I'll probably just back away and head to the city starport thing so that we can turn in what bonds we have. Because I really don't want to get blown up today. That's not a good way to start your series back up again, is by losing your ship. But I really do want to kill a bigger ship, like a Python or something, because it seems like the payouts have gotten way higher, and so I would kind of like to experiment with that and find out just how high they've gotten. Maybe hold together. Would be nice to have a chain gun on this rig at some point. I think I had chain guns, actually, but I'm not positive, but I think my Ferdy is tough enough that I think if my shields drop, I might be able to stick with him anyway and take him out, I think. I'm not sure. We're going to find out real quick. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Hold together. I'll repair you when we get back. Just hold together for me. Come on. Ooh, don't run into him. Woo! That wouldn't have been good. That power plant out. Take that power plant out. I need your power plant to be gone. Oh, come on. Stupid thing. You have 3%. I hate that. It's the nemesis in this entire game. Alright, let's go for life support. Since I know that way if his shields or power plant or anything comes back, there's pretty much nothing he can do without with no life support. There we go. Woohoo! Mean? Yes. Effective? Very. Though, I want to back up. Because as soon as he blows up, it's gonna boom. Interesting. I can't tell. You guys will have to let me know, because I honestly really don't remember, but you guys will have to let me know if that's a lot better, worse, or whatever. Wow, it's only 12 meters. That's crazy. So I may chill here for a minute, though. This is not easy. They've definitely... either the AI has been upped, I'm really out of practice, or they've made the chips harder to kill and made everything tougher. I'm not sure. I did read somewhere... I could be wrong, but I did read somewhere on a forum where somebody mentioned that solo play has made the conflict zones harder or something, like all the AI is attracted to the player or something to that effect, so that could be part of it if that's actually true. I don't know if it is or not. So anyways, yeah, that's kind of like I'm headed for community goals at the moment because I would like to, they're usually the best way for me to make money. Aside from bounty hunting, of course, which I can do more of that too. But, I was curious, though, if everybody... Because I know not everyone has expansions and stuff. I know Ships comes with the game. Horizons is the actual expansion. So, and whether you have beta access, I don't know. I don't know if Ships you have beta to anyway. One interesting thing that I did note was that the betas... There's two betas for Ships. There's a 32-bit and a 64-bit, and then it says the standard Elite Dangerous game is listed as 32. So I found that interesting, because it kind of indicates to me that when we move to the Ships update, and it actually gets, like, full release and not in beta or whatever, that would... imply, possibly, that they're moving to a 64, but I thought they were already running on 64, but I guess not. So that would be really cool if it actually makes the game run better, look better, whatever. That would be really neat. But yeah, I was just curious from mostly, I was kind of, this is just a run-of-the-mill, get back into the swing of things kind of deal episode. So bear with me in that regard that it's not a bit more structured and, I know exactly what we're doing. But, having said that, I'm talking, having said that, though, I was fairly curious to see what everybody kind of wanted to see in terms of, what? Repair all, but then there's 10 credits left. Okay. Paint. Yes, I want to repair my paint. Yeah, so... I don't understand why there's still 10 credits. Whatever. Glitch. Alright, let's check the bulletin board real quick. Because there should be a community goal, and then I'll finish what I was talking about. Basically, I just kind of wanted to know if you guys want to continue with the main game, or if you would rather jump to beta stuff and things of that nature. Wow! Okay, so we have 1 week... All you Imperial fans, get over here. So this has changed somewhat. Resist the Federal attack and sell your combat bonds. The Federation has discovered an Emperor's Dawn base in the Federal Senate. Yeah, and I'm completely out of touch with anything close to the story. Side with most bonds, collects, wins the war. Proportional contribution details. So first operation level is 1.8 million. Global progress is 764. So shouldn't we be past level 2? I'm confused. I'm gonna sign up, though. Whatever. Yeah. More than a little confused. Contributors 907. Is it glitched, possibly? Or... I don't know. I'm turning my stuff in because I want money. So, redeem all bounty vouchers. So, I had 92 grand of bounty vouchers just chilling. That's awesome. And we have 116. Oh, and I also have... my salary for that. So, that's cool. Yeah, I haven't checked any of the power play stuff either. I'm honestly thinking of dropping out of power play because it's like that. I'm considered hostile in this system. Because it's another power play person. I really just... It's enough work to keep up with power play that, yeah, the whole 50 million a week sounds good on paper, but I just... My play style is not conducive to that. I'm never gonna get there. Currently, I think I'm probably like a zero... or whatever. I'm rating 1. So I get 1,000 credits a week. Woohoo! Yay! You know. So, I think I might just leave. I'll wait and hear back from what you guys think and stuff like that, because this is marginally, kind of, sort of a group Let's Play, or a group character in a way. The short version is, let me know what you guys think in terms of wanting to continue with our standard play here and do community goal stuff and things like that, or would you rather jump over to ships and experiment? I'm not as big of a fan of that one for one reason only. It's one thing when the credits were lower, but a lot of these newer ships are really expensive, even in beta, because they're supposed to be like 180 million out of beta, so they're 18 million or something, and you can just see I had four. So I don't think the ship's beta is a really good idea for me, because I'm going to spend a ton of money on something that isn't going to transfer over when the full patch gets released. So it's kind of like, unless that's not the case. If somebody tells me, oh no, the cutter's going to stay with you if you buy it in beta, well, then 18 million is a lot better than 180. So there's that. But if anything, I would probably do the Horizons one, because I've seen tutorials and it's not super expensive to get a basic SRV and stuff and go exploring, things like that. So let me know what you guys think about all that in the comments and stuff. In the meantime, I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. A peace.